Hi folks, today we're going to talk about pill bugs, also known as roly-polies or wood lice. And as you can see, there's some of them there. So they are nocturnal crustaceans and have seven pairs of legs which are segmented sections like a lobster. They prefer humid environments, and being the only land crustacean, they can survive up to 30% dryness. They eat rotting vegetables and help nutrients get returned to the soil for plants to feed on. Even though they're called bugs, they're more related to crayfish and shrimp. And because of this, they literally breathe through their gills to exchange gases and need moist environments. They will die submerged in water. Like arthropods, they grow by molting their exoskeleton in two parts. First, the back half splits and comes off. Then the front sheds a few days later. So if you see a half pink pill bug, it is in the middle of molting. Mothers have a pouch on their underside called a marsupium, where they carry eggs. Eggs hatch and the babies stay in the pouch for a while before exploring the world. They can tolerate ammonia, which passes through their exoskeleton, so they don't need to urinate. Even though they can drink from the mouth, their butts have straws called uropods, which can do the same thing. I'm sure we know a few people with the same kind of skills.
They practice coprophagy, which is eating their own poop, because the poop contains important elements like copper, which it needs.
If they contact viral infections, they turn blue because the iridovirus reflects the cyan color. Their blood appears blue because of hemocyanin, which contains copper.
They can survive contaminated soil, unlike other bugs, because they can crystallize heavy metal ions midgut, like copper, zinc, cadmium, arsenic, and lead. This cleans up the soil and protects contaminated water. They can absorb moisture from the air, especially if the humidity reaches above 87%. Babies start out with six pairs of legs, and after the first molt, they grow the seventh pair. They speed up decomposing by processing decaying matter. Any gardener would be happy to see them in the garden. They return organic matter to the soil so that it can be digested further by fungi, protozoans, and bacteria. Just don't introduce them in the garden too early, or they'll munch on your young plants too.